Hey guys, it's Elena and welcome back to my channel. So for today's video, we're going to be doing variation 2 of the GlamLite V.I.P. box that they released on Black Friday, I believe it was. So here's the box here. And remember, everything is already like unwrapped and I already looked at everything because I tried recording this video and it just didn't come out the way I wanted to, which I explained in the first variation video that I did. So I'm going to try not to blab a lot and I'm going to try to be better with the way that I do this video. I'm trying to get better at the way I record and not be boring and all that stuff. So if you're watching this video and you have any suggestions on things that I can do better, please make sure that you leave them down below, because the only way that I'm going to get better is by you guys telling me what I can do. So with all of that mumbo jumbo out of the way, please make sure that you like, comment, and subscribe, because it really does help me. I do want to grow as like a beauty channel. Makeup is something that I really, really love. So yeah, I'm gonna stop talking. Okay, so we're just gonna get into the box. So I'm gonna show you everything that's in here. I'm gonna put all the prices on the screen and then I'm gonna calculate it at the end. I know that I forgot to calculate everything in the previous video, so I apologize about that. I need to go back and put it in the description or something. So yeah, but anyway, when you open the box, everything's all in bubble wrap and stuff, obviously, like each pizza palette slice. I know I kept saying pizza palette, but I meant slices. They're the pizza slices. So they also have the pizza palette, which they're known for, and then they have the pizza slices, which you're gonna see in here. I don't know if there's only two, which are these two, or if they have like multiple slices. I'm not sure, but let's go through. So there's supposed to be a value of up to $180, I believe it was. So yeah, we're gonna calculate all of that. Okay, first thing, you have a postcard. This just tells you a little thing about Giselle, which is the owner of the company. And then it gives you the GLAM15 discount code for 15% off. The first thing we have here is the Caribbean Glow, and this is the body luminizer, and this is in the shade Golden Paradise. If you watched the first variation video, then you know that there is a problem with these because there's no straw in the pump, so you can't get any product out. In case you didn't watch that video, here you can see there's no way for it to suck up the product and make it come out, so you'll just be pumping forever. Oh, it sounds like something finally came out. That's interesting. So I realize how dumb I sound and look, but if you watched the first variation video, then you saw how I like pumped and pumped and pumped and nothing came out, and then it decided to work in this video and make me look like a liar.
That's weird. Well, thank you for making me eat my words. It's pretty, but you can definitely tell that it's like not my shade. Like, I definitely could not wear that. And it feels like really greasy, so I don't like that either. Let's see what happens if I mix it into my skin more. Yeah, it just, I'm just too light for this. I mean, oh, my lights are really bright. But it's like really yellow. Like, you can kind of tell, but not really, because my lights are so bright. I'm just gonna take this off of my hand because it is kind of greasy and I do not like that. But I do really, really like the packaging. Like, the packaging that it comes in is really pretty. But yeah, cool. The next thing we have is another calligrapher pen. So if you watched the first variation, we did get one of these. And I really, really like it. It's not my favorite, because my favorite is the Hank and Henry Blickety Black one. Nothing is beating that one at the moment, but I do like this. I didn't open it because I do want to put it away, put it to the side for a giveaway, because I do plan on doing a giveaway pretty soon on this channel. The next thing we have is a highlight, and this is in the shade Sunkissed, and it is the GLAMLITE Diamond Luminizer. And it's like a pinky shade, which I will go ahead and swatch for you real quick. So there is, it's like a pink highlighting shade, but it's like, it's really pretty. Like, I personally like it. I think it's gonna look great. I'm excited. I haven't obviously tried any of their stuff other than the, the stuff that I just tried in the variation one box, and then their paint palette I've tried, which I really, really love that one. And then the next thing we have is a lip product, and this is, this one doesn't have the name on it. That sucks. Since I took it out of the thingy, I don't even know what lip product this is. I hate the fact that I don't know what the shade is, and I'm really sorry about that. Here is that swatch. So it's really nice. It's darker than the one that we got in the Variation 1 box, so. Okay, and the next two things are lashes, and then we have the palettes. So we have the Taco Lashes, and this is in the style Camerones. And these are the ones that I was saying that are dramatic that I absolutely love. Like, they're just so dramatic. Like, I just love them so much. I wish I knew how to apply lashes so that I could wear these, but I'm gonna practice because I really think that these type of lashes would really put together a nice, like, special occasion type of look. And this case that it comes in is, like, it feels nice, like, high quality. The next thing we have are the paint splashes, which was a part of the paint collection, and this is in the style orange. So these are really good lashes, just like your everyday lashes that still have some, like, flair to them. They're really cute. I like them. I think they're cute. Alright, and then last but not least, we have the pizza palettes. Pizza slices, excuse me. And I'm doing the same thing that I did in the first video, where I'm going to do two different looks using each palette. So first we have the meat lovers. So this opens like if it was a slice of pizza. And since I don't have my nails on, this is going to be a little bit more difficult. It opens like this. And there's the slice. On the back it does have ingredients and then a picture of the color story. So here's the color story here. I really like this color story. I think that it's really pretty. I do like my pinks. So I think that we can create a really nice look with this one. Alright, and the next thing we have is the Veggie Lovers palette. So of course it has the same thing on the back. It has the color story and the ingredients and a little bio. And then on the side it's cool because it has like a little ingredients thing, as if this was like a pizza that you bought at a store. I'm sorry, it's not focusing. Alright, so here is the palette. Here's the color story. I really like this one because it has greens, and I really, really am starting to like greens, even though I haven't really played with them that much. But I may get some really good use out of this because I wanted to do like a Christmassy look for tomorrow, because I'm having this like Christmas thing at my job, so I wanted to do like a look that would be Christmassy. Okay, so now that you've seen everything and then you've seen the prices of everything, now we can go into the look. Again, I apologize about not knowing what the shade of the lipstick is. I will try to find it on the website and I'll put it in the video if I can. But we get 8 products. I don't know if I even mentioned that in the first video, but you got 8 products in this box, 8 products in the other one. So I think that it's a really good, like, deal, like $39 for 8 products when the pizza palettes alone are like 20 or 40 bucks, I think, somewhere along the lines of that. So I think that it's really, really worth it. And I used a influencer's code, so I didn't pay like 40 something dollars. It was gonna be like 44, and then I used an influencer's code and it took $5 off, so then I only paid 39 and some change. So really, really good deal. And I love GlamLite. I love what they stand for. I love, like, Giselle, because she's a Latina woman owned brand. Like, it's just, I 100% support them. So let's get into these looks. I'm gonna stop blabbing now, sorry. Okay, so off camera I put my shadow shields on. I know I look crazy, but I mean, I think that they're even. Just in case you didn't watch any of my other videos before, I like to have that like cut type of look, so that is why I use shadow shields. Alright, so first I think we're going to play with Veggie Lovers, because I really want to play with the greens. Like, I really want to see how those perform. So I really think that I want to take yellow peppers, like, in my crease, so I'm going to do that. Yellow peppers is this shade right here. And I'm using a M441 Morphe brush. Ooh, that picked up a lot of product. There's kickback in here. I mean, not a significant amount to where it's like a deal breaker, but... So I know I forgot to prime my eyes, but... Most of the time, I don't really prime my eyes anyway, because I always do my eyes before I do like my face, so I don't really prime my eyes. Anyway, I know it's probably a bad habit. I should start priming my eyes, but I just personally don't do that, so not all the time, anyway. If I have if it's like a special occasion, I have somewhere to be in my makeup, I want it to like last, then I will use a primer just to ensure that my makeup does last, but most of the time I don't really care. That's just me. So the shade is there. Yeah, you guys can see it. I do feel like if I would have primed, I probably would have showed up a little bit better, because you wouldn't be able to see like my veins and my eyes, but it's not bad. It's there. I'm not trying to make this look complicated in case any of you are gonna like follow along or want to recreate it, because I'm obviously not really that great at makeup either, so I'm trying to keep it simple. So we might not use that many shades. But now I want to go in with Olives, which is this lighter green shade in the corner here. I'm gonna go in with that shade. And I'm going to put it exactly where I put the yellow. Which probably defeats the purpose of the yellow, but we shall see. Really, it's more in my crease than where the yellow is, because the yellow I took up a bit more, so you can still kind of see the yellow. Also, let me know what you guys think about the music in the background, because I feel like, I personally don't like silence, so that's why I like to play something in the background. I'm pretty sure the music is better than hearing, like, my annoying PlayStation noise. I took some more of yellow peppers to kind of try to blend out the harsh line that I'm getting from Olives. That's not seeming to do anything, so I'm gonna get a smaller blending brush. Maybe I just need a better angle. This is the Ipsy and Tetris collab brush. It's like a small, fluffy blending brush. Maybe taking more of Olives and blending it will help. I usually like to pack the color before I blend out, but just right here, it's just not doing anything. Like, you can still see, like, there's just a harsh line there. It's not really going anywhere. And now I'm going to quickly do the other eye to match this eye, and then we'll move on to the next step. Now I'm going to deepen it up. So I'm going to take Basil, which is the darker green color, and put it just on my outer V using the same Ipsy brush, because it's a small. It's pretty much this, like, very, very similar to Olives. Like, it's darker than Olives, but it's not really showing up like it is darker than Olives. I'm bringing that into my crease too to see if it can take away the harsh line Olives gave us. I really like this Basil shade though. It's so much nicer than the Olives shade. Kind of wish I didn't use that yellow at all, because it kind of looked like I have a zombie. It's like I have jaundice in my eyes. That yellow shade is just not a good shade for me. I'm gonna bring Basil in to like my thirds of my lid, I think that's what it is. So I'm basically just putting basil where we put olive to kind of like diffuse that mess we made. Well, that I made. If you're following what I'm doing, then what we made, but if you're just watching, I made. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. And alright, so now this is what we got so far. I really, really like it. I think it looks so cute. It looks so pretty. Alright. I really, really wanted to use mushrooms just in my outer corner to like deepen it up a little bit more, but I feel like I might mess it up if I do that. So I'm not sure if I should do it. Then again, I will never know unless I do it. So I'm going to take a pencil brush and just slightly dip it to mushrooms and put it in my outer V. That picked up a lot of product. So I'm just putting the mushrooms there and then I'm blending out with the Ipsy brush. I just took a little bit more of olive to kind of like diffuse. I feel like I put too much mushroom on this side. Doing the same thing over here. Alright, and I just realized that I left my eyeliner in my car and I don't feel like going to get it. So in this video, we're going to be using a different eyeliner. We're not going to be using the calligrapher one. If you want to see how that one performs, then go watch my variation one video and then I used it in there. I could definitely say right off the bat that they blend very well with each other. I'm going to use the Milani eyeshadow primer because my glitter primer's in my car. My whole makeup bag's in my car. I should help it stick. And this is in the shade Nude, in case you're curious, because I just noticed that it says a shade on it. Like a shade name. I didn't even know that they had shade names. It's almost like I'm cutting my crease. Alright, it doesn't need to be perfect because we're gonna clean it up anyway. Okay, I'm gonna use green peppers just because I want to use a bright green shade because that's like what I want to do for tomorrow anyway. So I'm using this Royal and Lagnicle from the Revolution brand. Royal and Lagnicle is the brand, but I'm guessing Revolution was the line. And this is the BX80, it's just a packer brush. I got this in an Ipsy box like years ago. Spray the brush. I'm gonna not spray the brush first. I'm just gonna go into it. This is how much product I have. And that's a lot, so. It's really pretty, but it's not as pigmented as I want it to be. Like, I want it to look on my eyelid how it looks in here, which I guess on the camera it kind of looks like what I want, but in real life it doesn't. So I'm gonna try wetting the brush. I'm using the Morphe Continuous Setting Mist. Ooh, that just went all over me. Alright, that definitely helped. Oh, and since I don't have nails on, I could probably even use my finger and see how it performs, because some shimmers perform a whole lot better when you use your finger. That looks really pretty, though. I really, really like this shade. Yeah, it's definitely performing a whole lot better wet. So, for these shimmers, you definitely need to use it wet then. For the paint palette, I know I said in my other video, sorry if you watched that one, it's going to seem redundant, but in the paint palette, the shimmers are really, really good. That formula that they used in the paint palette was a really, really good formula because you do not have to work with those shimmers at all. Like, you can go watch that video and you can see, like, the way swatching them even looked amazing. Like, I didn't have to do any work even with swatching them. They looked good. And they just went on so effortlessly. Like, these are good. Obviously, you can tell that they're buildable and you do need to apply them wet, but they're... Once you wet your brush, you can see for yourself, like, it looks so much better. Alright, so now I'm gonna go in with my Ipsy brush again, and I'm gonna dip into Basil, and we're going to add that green back over here. Just to make everything look effortlessly and blended so smooth. But yeah, now that we're adding that basil back, it definitely looks way better. Because you can see the like harsh line, and then now here it's kind of getting diffused a little bit. Slowly but surely, it's all coming together. Then I'm going to add some more of that shimmer, so I'm going to wet my brush again. And dip into Jalapenos. I'm going to be doing a get ready with me video soon, where it's like a get ready with me / get to know me video. I feel like I need one of those on this channel because you guys don't know anything about me. Right. I love. Okay, everybody, so here's the final look. I think that it looks amazing. Well, not the final look, because we still have to do our inner corner. We have to do the highlights and our tight line. So we're not completely done. For the lashes, I used the Tarte Big Ego for my eyeliner. My eyeliner, I used the Too Faced sketch marker. For my brows, I used the BH Cosmetics Studio Pro Ultimate Pro palette, and I use this shade right here. This is a really good palette. I don't know if they still have it because it was in their limited edition section, but this is a really, really good palette. And then for blush, I used the Juvia's Place Saharian Blush Palette Volume 2, and I used the shade Yara right here to bronze up my face. For foundation, I used Juvia's Place foundation in the shade Cebu 610. I did not conceal because my concealer is in my car. And I think that's it for the lips. I used the lip product that came in the box that I am not sure what shade it is, and I apologize again. Yes, I love this shade. Love it. I really think we're just gonna go in with Basil. Because I don't really think any other shade will look really good. I mean, we could do Mushroom, but then it'll be really brown. So we're just gonna do Basil. Thank you. So here's basil under there. I kind of want to add like a shimmer there. There's like a little bit of glitter that fell out from jalapeno that got on there, and it looks really pretty. So I'm gonna like get spinach and see how that looks there. Didn't add much, but it still looks, I still like it. All right, I like it. I'm actually gonna take the fluffy end and kind of like use it? What's the right word? Puff it out, blend it out. All right, cool. And then we have to highlight still. Yes! Queen. Oh my gosh, that's just, I don't know why I put it right there, like that's just not where it should go, but, and this brush is not my favorite either, like I want it to be softer. Now I totally understand why so many people were upset about this collection, because I mean, they're kind of scratchy and they're not really good. I don't understand that, because I have other Morphe brushes that are amazing, so. Yes, you can kind of see. I'm sorry about the lighting, but if I don't have it, it looks like shit if I don't have the lighting. This is like a glitter-based highlighter, by the way, so if you don't like that, you're probably not going to like this. I'm noticing that now. It's more of like glitter than like anything. And this, in case you're curious, is the Luxie 1010 Small Contour Brush. Luxie brushes. I'm just using it to like diffuse it. It's the first brush that I grabbed that worked for what I wanted. I do like the highlighter. If you like blend it out more, then it diffuses it so it doesn't look too glittery. Alright everybody, so here's the final look for the veggie palette. Now my final thoughts on the veggie palette. I love all of the shades in here and I love the look that came out. Let me know down below how you feel about the look. Even if you absolutely hate it, I want to know your thoughts. What could I have done better? What would you suggest? Now we're gonna move on to the next palette, the next look, which it's almost 8 o'clock here, so you're probably gonna get the second look a different day, but let's move on. All right, so now we are going to go into the Meat Lovers Pizza Palette. Okay, so I'm going to be using a Morphe M441. This is just my favorite brush to blend stuff in, to blend stuff out. So this is the brush that I use most of the time. And I did use a color switch to take off the green. It's just stained because I haven't washed it yet. Okay, so now I'm going to dip into Canadian Bacon, which is this one right here. And I'm just going to put that all in my lid. A little bit of kick up, but not a lot, not enough for it to matter. Probably should have used a smaller brush, but it's okay. I meant to put this just in my crease, but it kind of got in my on my lid too, so it's not a big deal. I can just cut my crease if I want the shimmer to show up a lot, but. Oh, and I forgot to put on Shadow Shield, which I should go ahead and do right now since I haven't gotten to this side, so I think that's about the same. You guys are going to know me as Queen of the Shadow Shields because I will always use them. I'm just not good at free-handing my eyeliner. I know that if I practice, I could obviously learn how to do it, but it's so easy to just put on like a shadow shield and then do what you gotta do. I don't know. That's just me. Okay, so now I'm gonna do the other eye, and I'm just gonna do it off camera to kind of speed up the process. Alright, so now that we have this eye looking like this eye, we are now going to color switch. So I'm taking crushed red pepper, and we're going in the crease. This brush is a little scratchy. I like to pack the color first and then blend out. I just find that that's a better method for me. I'm just trying to blend them together now. So I'm like blending up. Blend those two shades that we used together. Don't want any harsh lines, so... I feel like every time I do my makeup, I learn something new about like how I'm doing it, and it helps me eventually like get better. Or it is eventually gonna help me get better, but that's why I want to do my makeup often, and I want to upload often, because then if I'm uploading often, then I'm doing my makeup often, right? So that just means that I'm gonna get better because I'm practicing. And I know, like, my makeup is pretty much mediocre, but I get a lot of people that ask me, like, your makeup, or they say, your makeup looks so good, like, what products do you use, blah, 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 and I'm like, and then I have some people that are like, you gotta teach me how you do your makeup, and I'm like, it is so easy, because I'm not a professional by all means, so it's just, it's the easiest thing in the world. Let's move on. We're gonna smoke it out, so we're going to use sausage only in the outer V to like darken it up. And I'm just using a Morphe pencil brush. This is the M431. I like this one for laying the product there, and then I just go in with like a blending brush and do that. But I think I'm gonna try to see if I can just blend with this brush so I can avoid using so many brushes. I really gotta wash some of my brushes, so. I'm just putting in my outer V, and then I'm kind of bringing it forward just a little bit, because I don't really want to bring it too much forward. Gonna have to blend that out because this brush is not good for blending. And it's scratchy. I don't know what the hell. I'm dipping into Canadian bacon a little bit to kind of diffuse sausage. Now I'm going to dip into crushed red pepper and put it in the crease just to add some more like dimension or definition, however the proper word is that I can't think of. Oh girl. All right. Alright, now I'm going to dip back into Canadian bacon with the M441 brush, and I'm going to just bring it up here to add that lighter color back, and then blend them all together. And by them all, I really mean crushed red pepper and Canadian bacon, just blend those together. Okay, now I'm gonna do the other eye off camera and I'll be right back. So I'm going to spray my brush because I just found that it just works better when it's wet, so. using the continuous setting mousse to wet my brush. My battery is dying, so let's speed this up. I'm gonna dip into pepperoni. It doesn't really have too much shimmer in it, but let's hope that it looks better on the eyes. Alright, so here's pepperoni all over the lids. It doesn't look bad. My makeup look looks horrendous right now, so I'm hoping that it just comes out better than it looks. We're gonna try to save this look. So I think I'm going to take Red Onions, which is this shade right here, and I'm going to put it up here to kind of see if we can get some of that darkness out of there. I feel like it's just too dark. And if adding Canadian bacon isn't helping, that's the light pink shade we used, so. The shade Red Onions is super pigmented. Like, you can't really tell because of the darkness that was already there, but it's super pigmented. Just trying to get rid of any harsh lines, especially since we put that shimmer down there. I have a harsh line here because of the cut crease, so. I added Red Onions there, and now I'm adding Sausage, which is that brown shade, to kind of buff out and smoke out the corner so that you can't see the harsh line that we have from cutting our crease. So I should have did like a half cut crease. I don't know why I always take it all the way. I'm gonna do the same thing to the other eye. So now that I have my complete face done and on, we're gonna do the tight line and then the inner corner, and then we are done. Let's get into finishing our face. Also, so for foundation, I used the Milani Conceal Plus Perfect 2-in-1 Foundation and Concealer in Light Natural, and then I concealed with Juvia's Place number 19 Concealer. I set my face with Juvia's Place powder in Sahara. What else? My brows, I used the Billion Dollar Brow, the Micro Blade Effect, which is a really, really good brow. Oh, what else did I do to my face? I think that's pretty much it that I can remember. Oh, I didn't add mascara yet, but I can do that after we do our inner corner. So I need a pencil brush. Alright, so I got a pencil brush. This one is from the Moda Royal Magnifil collection, and it is the number 420 detail brush. I'm gonna use Ham. Ham is this bright pink shade right here, so we are gonna use that one. Yeah, it's so pretty. Can you guys even see it? It's really pretty. And I'm just building it just because I want to see how pigmented I can get it, but on its own, it's really good. Like, you don't have to keep going back in. It's good if you just do one, but I just like a super intense inner corner, so that's why I keep going in. That's what I really, really like about these shadows. They're super buildable, and that is what makes up for the fact that some of the shimmers you can't really get a lot on the first try, but like, they're super buildable and very blendable with each other. So, oh my gosh, I love it. Okay, spilled everything. So there, you can see the inner corner there, and that's the shade Ham. Oh, I love that shade. I just love it. My hair is crazy. I washed it and I didn't put any products in it, so it's all frizzy. I was gonna say fluffy. It's all freaking crazy. So for tight line, I'm using that Dose of Colors brush, and we're going to dip into Red Onions, which is this purpley pink shade right here. Which is like super, super pigmented. Like this shade is so pigmented. So now I'm going to throw on mascara real quick, and then I'm going to come back with my final thoughts. Yeah. Okay, alright. So for mascara, I use the Thrive Cosmetics Liquid Lash Extensions. This, I swear by this freaking mascara. I can't even tell you. It's like the best mascara I've ever used. And then I'm going to set my face with the Jared Cosmetics Slay All Day Setting Spray in the scent Dreamsicle. This is the Rich Luxe collaboration. This is my favorite setting spray in the world. It just smells so good, and it just keeps my makeup like in place. Like I swear I can hug a million people and it doesn't transfer. Also, when you accidentally get it in your mouth, it's really minty. Like, yes. I usually do setting spray before my mascara because this mascara is like not waterproof, so it comes, which is a good thing and a bad thing at the same time. The good thing is that when you take it off, it's super freaking easy to take off, like zero issues and no residue left behind. But if you get it wet, it's coming off, like it's coming off. But anyway guys, so this is the final look using the Meat Lovers pizza slice palette. And I do want to say that I love all of the shades in here, and I do love the way the look came out. Like, I'm telling you, it looked like shit in the beginning, and then now it's all put together. It just looks way better than it did in the beginning. Makeup always looks, well, at least my makeup always looks like trash in the beginning before, you know, it's actually done. So I'm glad that it looks better than it did in the beginning, because girl, I was struggling there a little bit. I was doubting that it was gonna look good. But anyway, the shadows, so they blend super easy with each other. They're really pigmented. The shimmers, you do have to work with to like build them, only some of them. Red Onions is super, super pigmented. That's a matte shade, and that one required no work at all. And Ham was super pigmented on its own without me having to like continuously go in. I just continuously went in because I like my inner corner to like be super like in your face. But Pepperoni I had to really, really work with. I don't know why, but I just had to really work with that one to get it to show up all over my lid. But as of, like, in a whole, the shades are really, really good. I think for the price, it's definitely worth it. I think this retails for $22. And I think that it's super worth it. They're, like, high quality. The mirror is good. The palette feels good in your hands. And then, you know, the box that it comes in is just so cute. It's, like, it's adorable. Like, on the side where it says ingredients, it tells you like the weight of the palette, and then you have, it says zero calories, and then their ingredients are right there. It's just so cool. Like, this is just awesome. And then they're cruelty free and vegan, so that's also a plus. So what else? I think that's pretty much it that needs to be said. I wanted to say thank you so much for watching this video and sticking around to the end. If you're still here, I appreciate you so much. Please don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell icon so that you can be notified every time I upload. And also make sure that you like the video if you enjoyed it, and share it with your friends so that they can see it, and subscribe if possible. That would be great. I love you guys so much, and I will see you next time with another one. Bye! I tried it once before, but I didn't get too far. Felt a lot of pain, but it didn't stop my heart.